Meanwhile, not far away, Mr. and Mrs. Arthur Pewty were about to enter an unfamiliar office.
Next! Are you the marriage guidance counsellor?
Yes. Oh, good morning.
Morning. And good morning to you, madam. Name? Mr. and Mrs. Arthur Pewty. And what is the name of your ravishing wife? Wait. Don't tell me it's something to do with moonlight. It goes with her eyes. It's soft and gentle, warm and yielding, deeply lyrical and yet tender and frightened like a tiny white rabbit.
It's Deirdre.
Deirdre. What a beautiful name. What a beautiful, beautiful name. And what seems to be the trouble with your marriage, Mr. Pewty?
Well, it all started when we first went to Brighton on holiday together. Deirdre, that's my wife, and I have always been very close companions, and I never particularly anticipated any marital strife. Indeed, the very idea of consulting a professional marital advisor has always been of the greatest repugnance to me. Although, far be it from me to impugn the nature of your trade or profession.
Do go on.
Oh, well, as I was saying, Deirdre and I have always been very close companions, sharing the interests, the gardening, the sixpenny bottle for the holiday money, and indeed, twice a month of an evening, settling down to do the accounts together, something which Deirdre, that's my wife, and I particularly look forward to on account of her feet. I should perhaps have said at the outset that I'm noted for having a grand sense of humour, although I've kept myself very much to myself over the last couple of years, notwithstanding, and it's only as comparatively recently as recently that I've begun to realise, well, perhaps realise is too strong a word, imagine that I was not the only thing in her life.
You suspected your wife?
Well, frankly, yes. A bit. Her behaviour did seem to me, who was after all there to see, to be a little odd.
Odd?
Well, to a certain extent, yes. Now, I'm not by nature a suspicious person, far from it. In fact, I've got something of the reputation of an afternoon speaker, if you get my meaning.
Yes, I certainly do.
And indeed, in the area where people know me, I'm in fact very well known.
Fine. Would you,
Yes, certainly. So I decided it was time to face the facts. Stop beating about the bush, or I'd never be able to look myself in the bathroom mirror again.
Look, would you mind, running along for, 10 minutes? Make it 20 minutes, all right?
Yes, I'll wait outside, shall I? Yes, that's perhaps the best thing. Certainly set my mind at rest on one or two scores there.
Pewty, are you a man or a mouse? You've been running too long, Arthur Pewty. It's time to stop, time to turn and fight like a man. Go back in there, Arthur Pewty. Go back in there and pull your finger out.
Yes. Yes, you're right. This is it, Arthur Pewty. This is your moment, Arthur Pewty! At last, you're a man! Come out of there, Deirdre! I know you're in there!
Go away!
Righto.